by a round of applause. Who was here yesterday for our DuckTales panel? How great was that, right? Well, the only thing better than ducks is Baymax. Don't call me on that. Teach his own. Welcome to the Big Hero 6, the series panel. I'm Mark Snedeker, an editor at Entertainment Weekly, and I love Big Hero 6. I'm the first to admit it. Who else here loves that movie? Who loves the comic? Yeah! And who loves the TV show on Disney Channel? Love that. Well, we're so excited because not only do we have all six members of the Big Hero 6 team in the house today, we've also got some really incredible exclusive stuff that only you guys are going to see, or also only you are going to see first. So without further ado, let's bring out the cast, shall we? All right. Before we do, let's get in the mood. You all know the Big Hero 6 theme song, right? And you know all of those incredible action sequences and the main titles on the show. But to kick things off, exclusive just for you, here's the extended, raw, first time anyone's ever seen this, never before seen full title animation for Big Hero 6, the series. Let's take a look. Producers and creators, Mr. Mark McCorkle. Keep it going for another executive producer and creator, Bob Schooley. Executive producer over here, Nick Filippi. He's the voice of Hiro Hamada and the leader of Big Hero 6. Please give it up for Ryan Potter. Let's inflate the love. Everyone give it up for the big guy, Baymax, Scott Adsit. She has the coolest purse of anybody I know. She's Honey Lemon, Genesis Rodriguez. Anyone here a fan of Wasabi? Give it up for Khary, Payton. She is the hero on wheels rolling in just for you guys. She plays Go-Go. Give it up for Jamie Chung. Fred is here too, late as ever. Give it up for Brooks Wheelan. Brooks, you are on time. Fred is on time. I am actually very happy about that. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks for throwing me under the bus.
So, guys, this is actually the first time, among the first times, the entire cast has been together all at once. Any first impressions? Any hellos? Any, oh, hey.
No, this is the only time we've been together.
We just met.
Well, moving in though, so it's.
Well, that's one of the things. We record everybody separately because everyone's so busy. This is the curse of working with talented people. They're always somewhere in the world doing something amazing while we're in Burbank.
And we found out very early that we can't stand each other.
I'm usually in Burbank with these guys, so. Not too busy.
So, for the producers, Mark, Bob, Nick, we were also excited to hear that Big Hero 6 was becoming a TV show. I think that was big news for any fan of that movie. What were the first big conversations you guys had when you found out you would be adapting this movie into a show? What were the biggest things you needed to hammer out?
One of the first, I think, was, boy, I hope we don't mess this up. But no, I think when Bob and I were invited to a screening early on, and you know, that last image of the team leaping at the camera, I think was a promise that there was more to tell, more stories, more adventures. But I think the other thing that really fueled us was, you know, Bob Lowe, you should say, it's your observation, you need to say it about science.
Yeah, we were really impressed with the movie and how it treated science as a good thing, and that's kind of in rare supply, you say. So we really wanted to sort of have this positive attitude about science.
And the idea of learning and being smart, that that's its own superpower. Like to us, that was
a
great
message. Definitely very geek empowering, I think. So, which was good for us.
Well, then we had the challenge of translating these characters into a fresh new look. We wanted to take the characters that everybody knew, but we wanted something fresh and something that we could do with the resources and schedule of the series.
Totally. Now, Brian, you have spent, I guess, a quarter of your life at this point playing the character of Hiro. Is that?
That's so weird when you
Very strange phrasing. What has it meant to you? Tell me a little bit about what playing Hiro has meant over the course of your life and how you've been surprised even by the role that Big Hiro 6 has played in your life.
I mean, I think it's not like I've done many roles, but out of all the roles that I've done, this is, I think, the most personal. Because it allows for a genuine, Asian American voice to come through. The other ones you kind of have to play up. I'm Asian. We like certain things, and this is our culture. No, it's like in this series, it's so colorblind to the point that I can just be myself and not have to play into being part Japanese. So it's been a very. I've grown up with this kid. You know, Hiro. I am Hiro. Hiro is me, and it's been very surreal.
Favorite word.
Scott, what about you?
Well, I've had to lean hard into being tall and white.
You really went deep. How has Baymax changed you? Are you a kinder, more helpful, more, you know?
No.
I think it puts my evil side in sharp relief, maybe. I think I really relate to the people who come up and say how it has affected their lives or made them happy or whatever, and that gives me a great deal of joy. And I think it does make me a little happier and therefore friendlier and therefore more lovable and huggable.
So if you see him later on the convention floor,
yeah,
put your arms around him.
Hug him tight.
Jamie,
I'm here for hugs if you want.
Jamie, I want to throw it over to you. Where were you when you got the call that you'd be getting another opportunity to play Go-Go? Had you secretly been hoping that you'd get another shot at this adventure?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Well, that's really loud. We found out, it's like a couple years ago, no? I feel like we've been working on this project for years now, and it's finally, you know, airing, but I can't even tell you where I got the news. But it was a couple...
It wasn't long after we
that
they kind of told us we might be doing a series, and then we were right in there. Mm-hmm. So we've been working on it since. We haven't stopped. It's not like we took a break.
Yeah. In Genesis, I mean, did you hope that this show would come alive, or was this a total surprise to you that Honey Lemon would get another shot?
Well, first of all, playing Honey Lemon is probably the best job I've ever asked for. So, all in all, I'm very happy with this character for such a long time. And you know what? Going back and throwing back to how we started, it's an attainable superpower. I think it's the most attainable superheroes that we can, see on TV. It's just apply yourself in school, and you can be a superhero as well. And to that, robotics, look into it, especially girls. They're doing really exciting things in robotics. I was on the robotics team. Yeah, so,
Baymax is based on real technology that they researched at MIT and other places. And all of that inflatable caregiver stuff is real. They've got prototypes.
Now, for any of the other returning cast members from the film, what was the most surprising thing you learned about your character in, you know, getting all this extra story, this new story, and new time to spend with these people? What did you learn that you didn't know before?